Currently, we have about 192 birds that have come in the last 6 weeks or so. That's the total number. A couple just came in this morning, only a few. And yesterday we had 86 birds come in one day. That's the biggest day. And some of you were here, some weren't. And mostly adult pelicans and a few turtles, and I'm not even sure they're oiled, and a few smaller birds. It's taking about an hour to wash each pelican, and we have to pre-treat them with a light vegetable oil that helps loosen up the crude oil. Then they get washed with Dawn detergent, and it's a intense process. The birds seem to be doing okay with it. They're healthy birds. So we got some baby pelicans that were taken from an island. I don't know their whole story other than I think they believe that the parents were oiled. Their parents could be here, we don't know. We've raised baby pelicans before, they're not difficult. We'd prefer that they're with their parents, but they're not, and it's the way it is. So, no, there's a few birds that have died. A few of the smaller species, gulls and herons, have died. And you know, they're all susceptible to it, but they particularly are because they're tiny little birds that struggle really fast and get exhausted and succumb to the stress of it. So they're taking them to the east coast of Florida now, I think with the assumption they'll stay over there, or at least they'll buy them some time. The juvenile birds probably are not that big of an issue. It's the older ones, so it's a risk, but they've made that decision.
Are you tagging the pelicans at all, or keeping track of them after they leave here?
The Fish and Wildlife Service does that, and they get it's called a federal band. So they get a silver band like this around their leg with a number on it, and that's theirs for their life.